Welcome back to my channel, everyone. Today, I'm going to show you how to add a new user to your WordPress site. Now, there are several reasons why someone would want to do this. And of course, if you are one of those people that have multiple people helping you with your business, and one of them is, you know, helping you with your WordPress site. So you may want to give them access without giving them complete access to your site. So you want to give them their own username and password so they can log in regularly. So now there is a way of doing this. So now if you are already inside of your WordPress dashboard, what you want to do is you want to go over to the left hand side and you want to go all the way down where it says users. Once you see users, go over to the right where it says add new and click add new. Now, once you enter inside of this page of the new user page, there are only a few things that you need to fill out. So you need to fill out your username, your email, and then we're going to scroll down and we're going to add a new password. So now let's start with the username. You can pick anything that is simple to use. I am going to click Sparky J and I'm just going to make the new username something simple, Sparky J. And then the next thing that we need to do is add the email. So I'm going to go ahead and add my email for this person. And now the email is added. And so this email is going to be the email that they use to log in. So of course, it would have to be their email. So you need to make sure that you get their email address in order to log in. And of course, you will give them the username. Now with the password, you know how WordPress uses its own generating passwords, but I like to use more personalized passwords, something that you can actually remember in your head, because these that they give have so many characters, of course you will never remember them. So we're going to just create one that is more personalized, and we're going to use some capital letters. We can use some other type of symbols, and we can just click something like, well, if we can add a different type of percent symbol here, and that would be it. We'll put next year, and so we have this right here. Live life, love life, however you want to, you know, make it out to be. All right, so now that we have this right here, the next thing that we need to do is we're going to look down here and we're going to keep this checked, because what this does is it will send the new user an email about their account. So this email address right here, at this address, the new user will get an email saying that an account has been created for WordPress. So we'll just keep that checked. Now what you'll see next under that are the roles, and this is extremely important because these roles will determine how much access a person has to your WordPress blog. If I click on the downward arrow, you will see tons of roles here. And I want to just talk to you for a second about the administrator role. Now, the administrator role should be your role, which is the role of the person that owns the website or your blog. That's the administrator. This role has all of the capabilities of doing any and everything to your site. So this person has complete access. They even have access and the ability to change your password. So you don't want anyone to have access to changing the password to your WordPress, because they can lock you out if you do that. So no one should have access as an administrator. You, the owner of your site, is the only person that should have access. That's the purpose of giving access to these other roles, so that they can have lesser access, but they can still have access, if you understand what I'm saying. You've got all of these different roles, and now if you want to find out more about these roles, then there's a link in the description. You can check out a video on those. But now what I want to say is, for this particular login or user, I am going to just give them user access as an editor. So we're going to use that as an example, because what an editor role will do is it will allow for you to edit all posts and pages. So you're not getting full access to everything, only being able to edit posts. So if someone is helping you to create blog posts, then this would be perfect for them. Now that we have established that role, then we're going to scroll down, which we're already down to the last of this page. So now we're going to go ahead and give them full access to the editor role. All you have to do next is click add new user, And once you add new user, you will see that this person has now been added to the new user page. So you can see up here it says users. You can see myself right here. And then underneath is Sparky J. So now that person should have received an email saying that a new user has been created. They have a new account. So let's go ahead and access, you know, that username and password. Let's try it out to see how it works. So what I'm going to do next is I want to log out of this so that I can re-log in under the new username. So I'm going to go up here to the top, click log out. So now that I am logged out, the next thing that I'm going to do is log back in. So we're going to go ahead and use Sparky J. Sparky J is going to be the user. And we've got that correct. And then we're going to put in, now you can use the user or email here, so it doesn't really matter. So if you want to use the email address, you can do that, or you can just use the username. So next, I'm going to put in the password. I'm going to go ahead and put in the password, and I will show you exactly what it looks like so that you know I put in the correct password. I'm going to click this little I. And that is exactly what we saw before. Make a correction. This is correct. So this should be it. The dollar sign, the percent sign. Now that we have that in there, we should be able to log in. So click log in. And there he is. Now up at the top, just to verify that we are in the correct one, if you look up at the top under user, it says right here, Sparky J. This is the correct account, and it's only going to give you access to limited access to editing posts. If we go over here and we look at posts, you're gonna notice that there's less over here on the left hand side, whereas before under the administrator when we just left, it was a whole lot more. So the only thing that you will be able to have access to are pretty much the posts. That's all that's going on. So we're going to hit click post, and it's here where you will be able to open up any of these posts and edit them, and you can do that really easily. Now over to the left here, it's got, you know, maybe like a contact form. The profile is going to be the profile of that person, of course. And if I scroll down, it's right here, Sparky J. So there's very limited access, and this would be specifically for an editor. So we're going to go back up to posts, and we'll be inside here. And actually, I'm going to go into the dashboard, and this is pretty much it. So this is how you add a new user to your blog. And if you want to be able to have them do specific roles, then you will adjust their roles accordingly. And also, if you want to find out more about how to use those particular roles, then you can check out other videos that I have here on this channel. Now, if you like this video, make sure you check out my other video, How to Add a Table of Contents to Your Blog Post. I've been creating several videos on my channel now, all about, you know, WordPress. So if you want to learn how to reset your password, if you want to learn how to add videos to your WordPress blog, then make sure that you check out a playlist that I have. All right, guys, thanks for watching this video. I will see you on the next one.